Well, it is welcome news and more than we were hoping for. The government announcing that from the 1st of June, pubs, cafes and restaurants will be allowed to host up to 50 people. There will be strict social distancing measures in place, though. This is what the Premier, Gladys Berejiklian, had to say earlier today.
Today, I'm pleased to announce that on behalf of the New South Wales government, New South Wales will be taking an important, critical and big step from the 1st of June, where pubs, cafes, restaurants and the like will be able to have up to 50 patrons. However, this will be with very strict guidelines in place. It has to be in adherence to the 4 square metre rule. So some venues are small in space. They will only be able to have as many customers as is allowed in that space according to the 4 square metre rule. And nobody will be able to take bookings of more than 10 people, a maximum booking of 10 people. And also, nobody will be able to be standing up in these venues. You have to be seated at a table, even if it's a pub. You have to be seated at the table. You have to be served at the table. There is no mingling, no standing around.
And for more on what these changes mean to our bigger venues, I'm joined by Ed Camilleri from the Central Coast Leagues Club north of Sydney. Ed, thanks for your time. Just take us through what today's announcement means for your club.
Well, it's an amazing announcement. We never thought we'll see people come back into the club. Last Friday, we allowed up to 10 people into the restaurant, but that was fairly small numbers for us to open. But for today, to have 50 people come in at any one time, one session, means we can open up our restaurant and get the club operating, partially operating again, and be great for our staff, getting people employed, great for the community. And I know a lot of people are waiting for the club to reopen again.
And I understand for venues like yours, where there's more than one restaurant, it's even better news.
Yes, we have a number of restaurants here, so we can have 50 per session, subject to 1.4 square metre rule on each of those. So, you know, it means that there's multiple choices here at the Central Coast Leagues Club, and other large venues have multiple restaurants as well, and we allow people in, especially on those conditions of having social distancing requirement for it. So fantastic news for us.
Ed, for venues like yours, they're not just venues, they're a place for the community to come together. What do you think that'll mean for the area to have somewhere to come back home to?
Look, it'd be so important for the community, for our membership of 60,000 people. We've contacted over 8,000 people so far, our members, seeing how they are. Most of them are itching to come back to meet their friends, have family connections, meet their employees that they serve, welcome to meet again, just their friendly faces. And it's such an important thing for clubs to be open, especially our club. And we're looking forward to greeting on the 1st of June.
Have you had any advice in terms of when gaming areas can reopen?
Not yet. I watched the Premier's announcement at 12:30 today. Nothing is yet, but we're hoping that will come shortly. Things are moving very quickly. It's only a week ago, clubs and pubs and restaurants and cafes are only up to a maximum of 10 people. Now we've gone up to 50 people. So we're looking forward to hearing that in the near future.
So what's your message to anyone who wants to book a table from June 1?
Please phone. We're taking bookings and we're really keen to get the business open. We're never designed to be closed. We're designed to be open. And this club's been open for 66 years now in operation.
Well, not long to wait now, Ed. We wish you all the very best of luck. Thanks for your time.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Okay, in breaking news, the Federal Treasury has admitted it's made significant errors in its accounting for the JobKeeper program. The blunder means the cost of the program is closer to $70 billion instead of the $130 billion the government expected. The mistake was discovered when the tax office found about 1,000 businesses messed up the enrolment forms when estimating the number of workers to be covered by JobKeeper. After being released without charge, the driver at the centre of the Greenacre crash has been rearrested. 14 people were injured when a car ploughed into a clothing store late yesterday. The 51-year-old driver was released by officers, but after further investigation, he was taken into custody again. Our reporter Grace Fitzgibbon will have more on the expected charges coming up after 4:30. Now to our UK correspondent Sophie Walsh, who reports on alarming figures which reveal just how many people in London have contracted coronavirus.
Well, the UK government says its antibody testing shows 17% of people in London have had COVID-19 and have developed antibodies. They've also announced a new test that they are trialling, a COVID-19 test, which delivers results in just 20 minutes, so they don't have to be sent off to a lab. And also from next week, 10 million antibody tests will be rolled out across the UK. Health workers will be tested first. We're also getting a bit more of an idea of what travel will look like post-COVID-19 from the European Aviation Safety Authority. Gone will be the days of those beautiful Love Actually reunions in the terminal. The meet and greets will have to take place outside the airport, and the only people allowed inside will be those who are flying. Face masks will be mandatory at all times, except for kids under the age of 6. And then once you're on board the plane, there'll be reduced food services and no duty-free on board to buy. And it will also be harder to go to the toilet. There will be one dedicated to the cabin crew and the pilots. And then for the rest of us, well, you can't line up and queue for the toilet because of social distancing rules.